This remote beach in the far southwest of England was a major target during the Second World War. It was so tactically important that the government's Petroleum Warfare Department installed flamethrowers all the way across it to try and repel anyone who might try to come ashore and sabotage what's underneath. Welcome to Porthcurno in Cornwall. Under here was how Britain talked to the world, and to a lesser extent, how it still does.
Under the Porthcurno beach ran the original telegraph cables linking Britain with her empire. What you're looking at here is the cable hut, which was the original landing point for the cables which ran from Porthcurno all around the world. There were 14 cables. The length of the cables amassed about 186,000 miles. The cables were dragged up the beach, terminated into old valve terminations in the cable hut, and then the message was relayed underground up to the cable station, which is the building that now houses the museum. These cables are fearsomely expensive to make and to lay, and the last thing you needed is some idiot dropping an anchor on them or snagging them in their nets. The beach has got very deep sand and it shifts all the time, so it's never been used for fishing. So you don't have boats landing here regularly, or you didn't in 1870. So it's a perfect place. We also have World War II tunnels. Back in 1939, when war was declared, we had Britain's premier communications hub in a very prominent white building, standing out on top of a cliff in a sparsely populated area, which wasn't the smartest idea. So 15,000 tons of granite was blasted out from the cliff, and the whole thing was moved underground.
A lot of folks think that when they're sending a message to someone in another country, it's getting bounced up to a satellite and back down. But unless you're in a really rural area, that is not the case. Most comms satellites are up in geostationary orbit, which means that they are falling around the Earth at the exact same rate that the Earth is spinning below them. But to make that orbit work, they have to be so far away that it takes half a second for a signal to get beamed up to them and back down. The route around the surface of the Earth is much shorter and much faster, and it doesn't involve blasting something into orbit. Undersea cables do have their own troubles, though.
November 2016, Jersey pretty much lost all its internet communication because a boat dragged its anchor across the seabed, took out three high-capacity cables, leaving just one, and Jersey was not cut off, but hugely reduced communications whilst they set about repairing them. When they laid the first cable out to the Isles of Scilly from Porthcurno, it was all well reported in the media about how they were going to get connectivity. What wasn't reported was that they actually made the cable too short. So what they did was they got an end of cable, connected this dead end of cable up to the landing station, and went, hurrah, it works, when it wasn't working at all. And then the media took all the photos, they went away, and then they put the problem right. So don't always believe what you see on film or YouTube.
There are still active telecom cables under Porthcurno Beach, although they're fibre optic these days and they don't surface at the Telegraph Museum's old cable hut here. They surface at industrial-looking buildings somewhere further ashore. One of those cables, called Flag, goes all the way from under this beach here to Japan. 15,000 miles of cable, stopping at a dozen other countries along the way, and it can carry up to 100 gigabytes of data every second. And it's just one of many that lands somewhere in this part of Britain. The fact that there's also several buildings owned by the British intelligence services around here is not a coincidence. So the next time you're in a group chat with people all over the world or video calling someone on another continent, just take a moment and remember that somewhere near you, there is a beach with your conversation literally flashing underneath it.